customized videos that an individual can create with me. I have done over 500 custom videos in the 2 years I've been doing them, and I cannot say that I didn't enjoy every single one. Very popular requests I do get from custom videos are my role plays, which is why I'm going to talk to you today, because in light of spooky season coming about and the holiday season coming about, my custom videos are extremely high in demand, and I have been so just overwhelmed with joy that you guys really enjoy the custom videos that I make for you. I mean, look at all of these unique role plays, trigger videos, and just unique videos I've done for people, including medical role plays, psycho ex-girlfriend role plays, saying someone's name in a very tingly way, cursing videos, and anything you can think of. So family, if you do enjoy a particular sorts of roleplay trigger that I do on this channel, you'd like to see more of it, consider requesting a custom video before my regular delivery becomes 3 weeks. And of course, you can always add on speedy and guaranteed deliveries. All of my details about custom videos can be seen on my custom videos website that you can check out in the description, as well as join the membership, because I have plenty of unique roleplays coming there in light of spooky and Halloween coming up, and you don't want to miss it. And did I mention members get discounts on custom videos for the holiday season? So join and support me today. Bye-bye. Enjoy the video. Thank you. safe room, and I just hope that you feel comfortable and trusting enough of me, and we will build this trust over time, don't worry. But I hope that for this first session that we can just get to know each other, address some of your concerns, and what do you want to get out of therapy? Perfect. Well, of course, I am a more free association type of therapist and mental health provider, but for these first couple of sessions, I will be sorts of leading the conversation. Is that okay with you? Of course, and the more comfortable that you get, the more you'll be wanting to express to me. Of course. Do you mind if I just look over some of your records here really quick on the clipboard? Perfect. Did you need water or anything? I have sodas in that little mini refrigerator as well. Well, whenever you need it, you go ahead and you just get up and go get it, okay? Of course. If there's something that's not in there that you want, let me know so I can add it to the collection. I just want you to feel some sorts of excitement coming in here. It's not always exciting talking about super deep and personal things, and I just want you to look forward to this. Therapy and talking about your feelings is something you should, and you hopefully will come to terms to being excited to talk about. So, alright, well, I'd like to first and foremost thank you for your bravery and filling out our questionnaire. Again, it's not super easy talking about super personal things, and your comment section was very much detailed, and I have to thank you for that, so that I can take lead in this. Perfect, but let's go ahead and just take some things here. This doesn't make you uncomfortable that I'm taking notes, does it? Of course. It can be sorts of, I don't know, this feeling that you're like a science experiment. I know from personal experience of in therapy, it's almost as if they're, you know, taking some sorts of samples from my brain, but it's just me jotting down some concepts that I see in here from you talking, and then I do much of my networking and analysis when you are gone, so it doesn't feel like we're really, you know, picking and prying at your brain, okay? Of course. So, session here, but just because we are a little bit shorter on time for this therapy session, of course I would like to extend our sessions to 30, 45 minutes when you are more comfortable, but again, this is the first time you're even meeting me, and I've shared a little bit about myself, and I'd like to hear a little bit more about you, if that's okay. Of course, you by no means have to, you know, say anything super personal, particular. You can just say whatever you'd like about yourself. Of course, you may go ahead. Of course. Yeah. Sure. Oh, what an accomplishment. Well, it is a super big accomplishment being able to go to work or school. Would you say now that school and work is a big part of your life? I see. Okay. How about family, friends? What do you like to do when you're not at school or work? Possibly here, but I would listens and is compassionate to what you're feeling. Someone that is more of like a life coach, as well as, you know, possibly being forced to be here due to some medical reason, or sorts of law. But there's many reasons why people come to therapy, and they're all very, very valid. So, yeah. Of course, that's a great reason to be here. It's a very brave and noble act to find the strength and bravery as you have to come and address concerns to someone that you know you probably don't have much personal experience with. But I hope eventually that we will come to more comfortable terms. Of course. Of course. And I'm always here to listen. You know, I may be jotting some things down, but my ears are always, always open to, you know, whatever you have to say, okay? Anxiety and possibly insomnia. Okay. Did you want to talk a little bit about that? What's been, you know, on your mind about those things? And of course, this is a very, very brief therapy session today, just getting the most basics and to possibly give you an activity to do on your own here. But you have made these the three, four part, and we will see in between these sorts of weeds and estens, the minor blips in between, but these are just going to be the concerns we're going to be going over today, okay? Of course, and we will flush these out eventually, but what we should realize is that anxiety and depression are more, you know, lifelong concerns that we have to be able to address and deal with. You know, it's not something that, you know, we can fix in a sense, but we can maintain it and we can learn to live with it. So if it gives you any hope, I personally struggle with these things as well, and it's not really giving my personal opinion ever. And I want you to know that when I say I understand through empathy and I understand through feeling and emotion. I don't necessarily know what you're personally going through, how to, and what you are experiencing, but I understand that feeling. And when someone says that they understand their feeling, it's not their certain situation, because you are ultimately experiencing something for either the first time, second time, but it is on your own experience. But we experience together through emotion and feeling. Do you understand? Perfect. And it's never, again, to give my personal opinion, but just for an understanding. Perfect. Alright. So, of course, you may ask a personal question from you. Sure. Are these things that you've noticed for a long time, short time? When did you believe that you first started experiencing, you know, depression symptoms, anxiety, and insomnia? Early childhood and later into middle school, high school. Okay. We do tend to see that these sorts of chronic illnesses do tend to spike up during these times. Now, there's no sorts of root causes. Sometimes it is due to, you know, your environment, but we often see that it's actually biological. Do you know anyone? May I ask a personal question? And of course, you do not have to answer personal questions, but I just want to be upfront with asking personal questions. Do you know anyone in the family that seems to be, you know, battling with the same issues as you? Okay. Sure. So I'm not sensing that it's deeply biological for you. You know, it might be due to situation, and we will get there eventually, and we will open you up to the more of my trauma sorts of trainings, but I do suspect that it is some environmental as well as biological, okay? But you do instance that it was right in the face. Sure. You can be as deep or superficial as you want with details. You do not have to apologize for cutting details out over explaining. I am here to listen again. My ears are open. For thinking it's not that big of a deal. Sometimes we just, as we grow and as little as you were, we have to remember to forgive our younger selves for how deeply we felt as we were younger. You know, we deal with the sorts of emotions differently. It is quite literally the first time you're experiencing these things, and if things get, you know, sort of confusing, we can sort of hash them out and make them, you know, cut, and how we are feeling. But of course, everything you felt and are feeling is valid. It is. Yeah. Well, if you've never been told that it can come as a shock that someone actually cares for your emotions. Yeah. And again, everybody experiences something different, and someone's reaction to a situation doesn't make your reaction less so. Yeah. Actually, your emotions might be enhanced because you do struggle with depression and anxiety. Yeah. Your emotions are valid. Yeah. But you do think it comes from this sort of era of your time. Sorts of looking to do with, you know, therapy in conjunction with those issues? Are you looking for someone to just hear you on these things? Are you looking more for more personal and applicable use of practicing? Sure, of course. Yeah, I already have an activity in my mind for you, just because you are sort of not, and I'm not saying this to be, you know, judgmental, but you are stuttering a bit, and it seems like your brain is thinking of so many things that come to mind when I think, or when you think of the word depression, when you think of the word anxiety or insomnia. A lot of things seem to be going through your mind, and I can see that the wheels are sort of turning in there. So I do want to just recommend that you start. Have you ever tried journaling before? Yeah. It's sort of similar to doing like a diary, but instead journaling helps you sort of just get and flesh out all your ideas, and actually elicits you to sorts of put into words how you're feeling. Well, it can be every day if you wanted to, but it is ultimately whenever you want to. Yeah, I often recommend just keeping a small notebook, even a pad of paper next to your bed or somewhere that you're often by, and whenever you sort of have this overwhelming feeling or sorts of stress, or you need to get something off your chest, you know your journal is always there for you. And I do heavily recommend this, and that you bring your journal to these therapy sessions if you're comfortable enough. And I totally, I mean totally understand that these things can be very personal, so again, it is up to you and how much you are willing to say. And I am not going to consequence you for leaving details out, but I do think this is a very good practice to implement in your life, just so that you feel just a little bit less overwhelmed in the head of yours, because I see that you're struggling with just how you're feeling about things, which can elicit anxiety. And because, you know, we can't get it off, you know, we don't feel like someone's listening or will understand us, at least getting it into words and on a piece of paper gets it off of us, and it can actually alleviate some symptoms of depression, as well as ongoing thoughts that can cause insomnia. Yeah, would you like to try this out before our next session? Super. I will just write down that we're going to try this out. Of course, this is not a one-all catch-all. We'll just see course, it's not something you have to do every day, just whenever you feel, you know, you'd like to just get in tune with maybe your intuitive side. Are you intuitive, you think? Yeah, or are you more factual? Similarly, with different situations, of course, like I've mentioned before, but you are not alone.